Sorry, I'm late. I've had to catch up on some work. Well, how is she?
I had to call the doctor again. He's given her a sedative. Did you have to go back to work?
Well, there's nothing more I could do here, Catherine. You know that. She would have needed you more than me. I think the sooner we all get back to normal, the better it'll be for all of us.
I forget what's happened, you mean?
Oh, no, of course not.
Ken, what are we going to do?
Well, there's nothing much we can do now. Let the police handle things. Although...
Although what?
No, nothing, love.
Now, come on, what were you going to say?
I just... I don't think they're going to catch this, Black Love.
But they've got to.
Oh, what if they do? What then? Just means that Sarah's going to have to go through the whole thing again. Relive every moment.
Oh, God, don't you think I know that? She's my daughter and I know what she's going through. She's going through hell because some animal. Well, he's got to be punished. He's got to be made to suffer. He's not going to get away with this. I won't let him.
Are you on duty in the grounds today?
Yes. The prisoners aren't too happy about being
watched
all the time.
Their opinions don't interest me. Make sure everyone coming into the prison is thoroughly searched. No exceptions. And precisely what do you think you're doing, Miss Bennett?
Well,
it looks to me as though you're going through my office files.
It's this business of Ferguson. I don't like it.
What exactly don't you like?
Well, it's been worrying me, so I took the liberty of looking through some of the files.
Oh?
Ferguson's not the type to be involved with drugs. I've checked her record. No history at all of drugs. Ferguson's a thug. You know, I don't think she's smart enough to handle drugs.
I don't think there's anything smart about handling drugs, Miss Bennett.
That's not what I mean. I think she was set up, framed.
Who'd want to do that?
Who needs a reason? If these women behaved rationally, they wouldn't be here in the first place.
All right. I suppose it is possible Ferguson's telling the truth. What's the reaction from the other prisoners? That's usually a good guide.
Well, Smith and her cronies are all up in arms.
We can ignore that. They're good friends. But we do have a growing number of drug offenders. I'll look into it and give you a list of those prisoners with drug records. But in future, come to me with your suspicions.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
And keep a close eye on all of them.
Does that include your niece?
Of course.
And how poor old Money's going in solitary.
Mongrels. I'd shoot the lot of them.
Shoot Money?
No. Whoever put the pills in her cell.
Oh. It's amazing this stuff still works.
Looks like Heath Robinson designed it.
Yeah, it does a bit, doesn't it?
Somebody must be trafficking in the stuff.
Well, there's always a market for drugs, Bee.
Yeah, and more's the pity.
Bee's kid died from an overdose.
Oh, well, you shut up. Talking about it won't bring her back. But just you wait until I get my hands on whoever framed poor old Monica.
Well, I've heard marijuana doesn't do too much harm.
It isn't just that stuff. It's all the muck they mix in with it.
Yeah, that's how they get them hooked. Can't do without it. Need it more and more. Well, the bloody pushers don't give a damn. Fortune they make.
Yeah. All the kids out robbing banks to pay for it. Shocking how they put up the crime rate.
You. Outside.
You gotta hand it to old Vinegar Tits. Even if she is the governor's niece, she don't care.
We could get God in here and it wouldn't impress Vera.
Don't you play any of your tricks on me.
I was trying to help you.
Help me? I've been through the files.
Vera, listen to me.
Monica wouldn't touch drugs. It was you who received that parcel.
Of course.
You who wanted the drugs.
To plant them on Monica, to help you.
Well, where's the rest of the stuff?
Oh, this is ridiculous.
You should be grateful. I was trying to make you look good in front of Auntie Erica.
Grateful?
Yes, grateful. Well, just remember, we're in this together and you've got more to lose than I have, so you better be nice to me. For a start, I'd like to get out of that laundry. Oh, and don't forget the colour TV. Or just a small one.
Don't push me too far, Davidson.
Sorry, Vera.
You don't have much choice, do you?
Where is she?
Just upstairs cleaning her teeth. She'll be ready in a minute. Can you pick her up from school today?
Yes, of course.
Not sure she should be going back. Don't think she's ready.
Well, at least it'll keep her mind occupied. She won't have time to think about other things. See my keys anyway?
She's not going to forget that easily.
Maybe I should keep her home. She's still very nervy.
So she needs something to keep her occupied. Look, I know it's hard, but moping around the house won't help her now, will it?
She is our daughter, Ken. Don't you feel any protective instinct towards her at all?
Well, I'll see what I can do. The more fuss we make, the worse it's going to be.
Well, I won't have a moment's peace while she's out of my sight.
Ah, there's my girl. Neat as paint and ready to take on the world, right?
We've got tennis today, Mum. You can have a note to say I can't join.
Yes, of course. Here's your lunchbox. And your father will be at school to pick you up directly afterwards. You still look very peaky. Are you sure you want to go? Well, all right. But if you feel upset, you tell the teacher to phone me and I'll come straight round and pick you up.
What a dump.
Well, it's somewhere to sleep, isn't it? It's
got to be somewhere better than this.
Yeah, well, we haven't found it. Want a cup of tea?
2 days in a place like this, it's going to take more than a bloody cup of tea to make me feel better.
We can't go and stay in a hotel, can we?
Turn that row off.
She's still here.
A couple of good things for the races today. Here's when I set my mind on, I can really pick him. And you're always bloody well here, aren't you?
No, it's me bloody ghost.
Oh, a comedian.
Now look.
I told you I don't want her around. She gives me the creeps.
You want to know what you give me?
Oh, come on, Toddy. We've got a good thing going and Frankie's not in the way.
Yeah, no more than a bloody plague of locusts. Right, you, out.
You gonna make me?
I don't much care, really. Either you go, or you can both get out.
I'll be all right. Honestly. Do you want a cup of tea, then?
Forget it. Come here.
We shouldn't have let her go back to school so soon.
What else could we do?
Well, I could have kept her home with me.
Just about the time. I better be going. All right, I'll get it. Oh, Ken Roberts.
Yes, Mr. Jeffries. Huh? Well, what happened exactly? I see. Yes, well, I'll be right round.
What is it? Is it Sarah?
Yes, it seems she fainted in assembly. I better go and pick her up.
I'll go.
There's no need.
You're late already. I'll get her. I told you so.
Wonder where Madame Barbara is.
When the governor's niece, she can get away with murder.
Oh, well, she didn't, did she?
Wonder if she knocked off. Probably one of her ritzy boyfriends.
How do you think she did it?
Well, suppose you ask her when she gets back. She's probably having a chat with Auntie and catching up on all the family gossip.
Davidson won't be working here any longer. She's been transferred to the garden. I hope you can manage on your own.
Well, like I always say, it's not what you know, it's who you know.
We could have guessed.
If it had been up to me, I would have given her no special treatment. People like her don't deserve it.
Ooh, knock off someone you was fond of, did she?
Is that what she told you? That she's in for murder? And I thought you knew everything that went on in this place, Smith.
What did she do?
Miss Davidson was caught smuggling drugs.
There you are, darling. Just sit down. Here we are. Put your legs up. Come on. Make yourself nice and cozy. There. Now, is there anything else I can get you? Glass of milk? I told your father this morning that it was too soon for you to go back to school. I think you should have the rest of the week off and just take things easy. I'll phone the doctor.
No, Mum. Please.
Well, he left some sedatives. I'll get one of those.
Everyone looked at me. So I was dirty.
Oh, darling. Now, just you rest and I'll get that pill. Here we are. Oh, I didn't tell you. The travel agent phoned yesterday. About that trip to Noumea? I've got a surprise for you. We're not going to be on the mainland. We're going to be on one of those divine little desert islands. There'll be plenty to do. Lots of exploring, snorkeling, picnics. Sounds gorgeous. Shall I get you some lunch?
I'm not hungry, thanks.
But what about a nice quiche and some salad?
No, Mum.
Oh, but you love quiche. And you've got to eat something.
Hello, Senator Roberts. I'm Jack Harris, I'm 80 your dad.
Yeah, look,
Jack going round to your place for dinner tonight,
will
he turn?
I know, Dad told me.
Well, I'm going to your place now, would you like to listen?
Jack Harris,
80 your dad.
Thought it was you.
Florence speaking. What is it now? Can't you do anything on your own? I told you not to ring me at work. Look, I can't take time off to take the cat to the vets? Do it yourself. You wanted the damn thing in the first place. Yes? All right. Silly bitch. Mr. Roberts, what can I do for you, sir?
You got the monthly list of foreign exchange contracts ready?
Yes, they're in here. I just have to lay my hands on them. Shall I bring them in to you?
I don't know. I'll wait.
Excuse me for asking, Mr. Roberts, but is there anything wrong?
Hmm?
Well, you don't appear to be yourself. I thought perhaps that...
Oh, no, there's nothing wrong. I'm just a bit overtired, I guess. Are those the figures?
Yes.
Don't get yourself into a knot. I know what I'm doing.
How do you know what the drugs look like? I mean, you can tell with booze, because booze is in a bottle.
Will you get outside and keep watch?
Okay. Supposing there aren't any drugs in here?
Oh, don't be bloody stupid, Lizzie. She's got to be the one that set Monty up.
Oh.
There. Well, knowing it's one thing and proving it's another. Little Miss Lardida couldn't have blown the lot on setting Monty up.
She's got to have more of the stuff stashed somewhere. Supposing you do find something that's only aspirin.
Well, you get outside and keep watch for the screws.
All right.
Oh, there's nothing in here. The kid's sneaky. She's probably got the stuff on her.
Well, what can you do now?
Well, wait until we get her alone. That's going to be bloody difficult with screws everywhere you go.
Oh, you'll think of something, do you?
Mongrel. I'll kill the bastard.
He's gone.
I'll find him and I'll kill him.
No. You were right, Franky. We shouldn't have stayed here. He hurt me, Franky.
Bloody murder him.
No. I just want to get away from here.
You look after yourself real well when I'm not here, don't you? Here, give us a look at your face. Oh, Jeezy, you're going to have a shiner in the morning.
I don't want to stay here, Franky.
He won't be back till tomorrow, will he? Mm. So we're in no real hurry.
I really don't want to stay here, Franky.
Now, look, you've got to have somewhere to stay tonight.
Yeah, but...
You've got to have your rest. Besides, I've got my own reasons. Well, I won't let him hurt you, Doreen. Just leave everything to me. Damn the bloody screws. You can't move.
Yeah. Makes a person feel you're not to be trusted, don't it?
Not exactly Kew Gardens.
What'd she say?
I don't know. Just wave. Silly little bitch.
How are you going to get it?
I don't know. Listen,
You go up to the prison officer and say you're not feeling the best. You think you're going to have another one of your turns. Get her out of the way. Think you can manage that?
Of course.
Right. Well, get on with it.
Oh.
What are you two doing out here?
Oh, me hat. Not me hat.
What's the matter with you, Birdsworth?
Nothing.
Well, get back inside, the two of you.
Bloody hell. Go, Franky. He'll be here any minute.
Good.
Please, Franky.
I've been telling Doreen, don't worry. Everything's going to be okay.
Franky, please.
Thought you'd have left.
Without saying goodbye. I've been thinking, Toddy. I reckon it's Doreen's turn to take a walk this morning.
Hey?
Yeah. And it's about time you got yourself a real Sheila. What do you think?
No, Franky.
It's okay by me.
You, like to play it a bit rough, don't you?
Please, Franky.
Shove off, Doreen. Shove off. Out! Let me show you what I've got. You're really going to enjoy this morning.
Christ.
What's the matter, Toddy? Scared? Well, no, not you. Not a big bad bastard like you. You like to beat up on little girls, don't you?
And now listen, Frankie, on it.
Shut up!
To Lynn Warner. She's due back here today. I believe you've been visiting her in hospital.
Yes. I've arranged for her to see a lawyer.
What's your opinion of her mental condition?
Well, she's pretty down, but I think that's understandable.
I see here they've had her on sedatives. That will have to be discontinued.
Oh, yes. That can only add to her depression. I think the most important thing is that she's kept busy and left alone as little as possible. If we could interest her in one of the courses available... Just something to keep in mind of her own immediate problems.
We'll put her back in the garden. She's always like that. Perhaps you could have a word with her. Suggest some of the other things she might be interested in doing.
Right. And if she could share a cell with someone her own age, preferably somebody a little less, tough.
You mean not one of our old legs?
Right.
Yes. Yes, I think we can manage that.
Sharing a room, it's like being back at boarding school.
You'll soon get used to it. This is Barbara Davidson, Lynn. She'll be sharing with you.
Hi.
This place has all the charm of a tenement.
Now, you settle down. I'm sure you'll get along just fine.
Are you the one who slashed her wrists? Really is like the old school. Oh, I'll swear they've even got the same beds. Did you go to boarding school?
No, I lived on a farm. I went to a country school.
It's nice. I always thought they were quite alike, really.
What?
Boarding school and prison. Both of them have these ridiculous rules and you're stuck here. But where there's a will, there's a way.
As they say.
Uh-huh. Okay, now you listen to me. You've been promising me for weeks to get a plumber. Do you want me to drown? Well, either you send me a plumber or I'll sue you. Oh, yes, I can. The water's ruining my furniture. To say nothing of my disposition, either. Yes, well, I'd do that if I were you. Thank you. Goodbye. Cretin. Well, how are you?
Not bad. Problems?
No, not if you're a duck, I suppose. I'm going to have to move from that wretched place before I get washed away. And I've invited Greg to dinner. I hope he's got webbed feet.
Well, I'm sure he won't mind if you put him off.
It's all very vague anyway. Hey, listen, I owe you a dinner too. Well, why don't we make it a threesome? Just as soon as I beat my agent in producing a plumber, all the water just naturally seeps down to the flat below. Do you want something?
No. I heard you were looking for me.
No. Oh, yeah. It's about the searching every time I come into prison. Oh, how much longer is it going to go on for? It's driving me mad.
Well, we're being searched, too. I mean, everything's been tightened up.
Yeah, well, I know it's necessary. Sometimes it's quite embarrassing.
What's going on? We never had all this fuss before.
Governor's orders.
Well, I always say it's nice to be kept busy.
Oh, hello, Lynn.
Keep moving.
Oh, come on, Vera. We only want to say hello to Lynn, sort of welcome her back and fill her in on all the gossip, you know.
All right. 1 minute. Come on, Davidson.
How are you, love?
Okay.
That's nice.
Well, I'd better be going.
We want to talk to you.
What about?
You're in with Barbie, baby, aren't you?
Yeah.
Then you can do us the little favour.
What sort of a favour?
We want you to search her clothes for drugs.
I don't know anything about drugs. No way.
You have to, love. You're the only one who can. And you wouldn't want to upset me, now, would you?
Okay, but what if she catches me?
I've thought of that.
How's she been today?
Oh, still very quiet. Police were here again. They showed her what they called mug shots, but she didn't recognize anyone. They're going to come back again with some more books. And they want to do a lineup.
I don't like it.
Neither do I. But we've got to catch him.
Why? Maybe it'd be better if we just drop the whole thing.
Ken, there's someone out there attacking young girls. It's not just Sarah. What if he attacks somebody else?
Look, I understand all that, love, but what if we do catch the man? Why, you heard what the police said. You saw the doctor's report. All that shows is that Sarah's not a virgin. Rape cases are very hard to prove. It'd just be Sarah's word against the man's. I just don't think we should expose Sarah to that sort of ordeal.
lost something?
Look, I'm sorry, but...
But?
Well, when I was in hospital, they had me on these pills, and now they won't give them to me anymore, and I thought...
And you thought what?
Well, sometimes you can get them in here, but with all this searching going on, I haven't had a chance, and, well, I was just wondering if maybe you had something.
I might. Depends.
Have you?
Oh, now, hold on. Have you got any money?
No, but I can get some.
Well, when I get the money, you get the pills, okay? Nothing's for nothing.
Make it snappy. Warner, Davidson, get a move on.
In a bra.
All right, Lizzie, get a move on.
Just keep her still.
Got him?
Oh, look like the stuff they gave me for me flu.
You little bitch. Oh. My daughter died because of people like you.
I never meant to push the drugs.
Oh, I suppose you never meant to put those pills in Monnie's cell either.
You bloody drunga.
I ought to kill you, and it's all your lot deserves.
Oh, get up. Not so bloody high and mighty now, are we?
Oh, don't you, wouldn't?
Oh, wouldn't I just? Your hanging's too good for you. Anyhow, I've got a better idea.
Oh, please.
Oh, please, and I'm sorry. You make me sick. Here, how many pills you got there, Lizzie?
Oh, there's a lot. Enough to kill an army. Let's see how you like a taste of what you've been dishing out. What do you say, Lizzie?
Yeah, she gets, deserves everything she gets.
You better get your hook on my bloody stuff.
You hurt me?
Oh, I reckon there's enough here to kill someone. Well, how about that? Hold her still. Isn't it sad, Lizzie?
Yeah.
Just another junkie who didn't know when to stop.
Yeah, very sad.
You screws couldn't find Ayers' rocket was in your flaming living room. There, your pills, your merchandise, and your push-up.
I would save my breath if I were you.
You two, out.
God, is that all the thanks we get?
Yeah, I reckon we deserve a reward.
Get out.
Next time you want some help, don't send for us.
You better take them to breakfast. I'll handle this.
All right, you. On, move it. Get out. Out.
You've got to help me.
Help you? I can't help you.
Oh, they tried to kill me.
If they wanted to kill you, you'd be dead. Now get up.
Where are you taking me?
To see your auntie. I'm sure she'd be very surprised to know that it's her dear little niece who's been causing all this trouble.
I'll tell her. I'll tell them it was your idea.
You've already got the other girls against you. Involve me and you won't have a friend left in the place. You won't last 5 minutes. I don't think your aunt's going to help you. Now move. Move!
The space web. I want G-force taken out.
I don't want you to pick me up from school anymore.
Oh, but your father and I are only trying to protect you, darling.
Protect me?
All you're doing is making me look an idiot in front of the other girls.
It's not the other girls that I'm interested in. It's you we're worried about.
Do you want any help?
No, thanks, darling.
Beth's having a party next Thursday. Be all right if I go, won't it?
Well, I think we'd better speak to your father about it first.
Oh, Mum.
Well, we don't know Beth very well.
I know her. What do you want me to do? Bring everybody in the school home so you can look at them?
Of course not. Will her parents be there?
Yeah.
Well, then I expect your father will say it's all right. I've run out of oil.
I'll go.
Oh, I'll get the keys.
I said I'll go.
I thought you'd want me to drive you down there.
What's the point of me going? You may as well get it yourself.
Okay, fine, fine. While you're down at the shop, will you get me another carton of milk?
Hello, love. Haven't seen you for a couple of days. Been off colour, have you? Yes, there's a lot of it going around. My Sid had it, and his Daphne, too. Hers was a bit different, but the doctor said it was probably the same strain. Is that what you had, then?
What?
The wog.
Oh, yeah.
Did you want something, then?
Cooking oil and a carton of milk.
There's the milk. I'll get the oil. Your mother likes peanut oil, doesn't she?
Yes.
Love, in the back. Well, you know where it is. Good morning.
Now, Sarah, don't panic. Just stay where you are. You'll be perfectly safe with Mrs. Heath there.
I'll be right down for you. Sarah, for heaven's sake, stay where you are.
I'll be right down. Police.
My dear. Sarah. Child, whatever's the matter?
Is there a man out there?
There's a man in the shop, yes.
Mum said to stay here with you. She's ringing the police and...
The police?
That man. He raped me.
Well, what have you to say for yourself? Did you have anything to do with the drugs found on Monica Ferguson? You're not helping yourself by your attitude. Very well. I have no alternative but to place you in solitary confinement. Take her out. Not you, Miss Bennett. I see you were the officer present when Barbara received the parcel.
I thought
you are supposed to check every item thoroughly.
She's your niece.
Being my niece has nothing to do with it. I told you she was not to receive special treatment. That'll be all.
How long will we keep her in solitary?
That depends on the visiting judge.
Ah. Ah, finished for the day?
Yes, thank goodness. You're looking very lonely over there. I thought there were supposed to be two officers on duty.
No, we got to the bottom of that.
Who was it?
Barbara Davidson.
Well, well, well.
So all you have to worry about now is your wet flat.
About that dinner that we were going to have.
Mm.
Well, my flat's very small and,
Yes?
Well, your flat's big, so... Mm. So I thought that
you
maybe...
You thought that we'd have dinner at my place?
No. I thought I'd move in with you. I'm a lousy housekeeper, but a brilliant cook.
Really? Well, I'll just have to think about that.
Good. See you later.